Hello, welcome to LMU Tri-State News. I'm Ashley Hurley. Thank you for joining us for another edition of local and campus news, sports, and entertainment. Let's get started with this week's top stories. It is never too early to start preparations for Relay for Life, and LMU is already on top of planning. Coming up this week, a bag lunch special will be offered from 11 o'clock to 1 o'clock on the second floor of the DeBus College of Osteopathic Medicine. This week's lunch will include a chicken wrap, chips, drink, and a sweet treat. Sweet treats will also be on sale, and along with a drawing for a prize basket. One ticket costs $1, 5 tickets cost $3, and 10 tickets cost $5. There have already been approximately $600 raised in sales from the lunches, and all proceeds go to Relay for Life. If you would like to get involved with Lincoln Memorial University's Relay for Life team, you can go to www.relayforlife.com and select Get Involved, follow the instructions, and search Relay Rail Splitters. Once you have selected Join Our Team, you can choose your payment method. Relay for Life takes place each year at the Harrogate Park and is scheduled this year for Friday, September 12th. The Omicron Delta Kappa, known as ODK Circle at Lincoln Memorial University, will host local artist Jimmy Rose next Wednesday, March 12th at 1 o'clock p.m. in the Tex Turner Arena on the LMU main campus. Rose, a native of Pineville, Kentucky, gained national spotlight in fall of 2013 when he became a finalist on the NBC television program America's Got Talent. Rose, a Marine veteran and former coal miner, became known for the original song, Coal Keeps the Lights On, which he performed on the show. Rose finished in the show in third place. Rose will speak to the audience at 1 p.m. on March 12th and will finish his presentation by performing several songs. Rose's appearance is funded by a Maurice A. Clay Leadership Development Initiative grant from the National Omicron Delta Kappa Foundation. The presentation is free and open to the public. Local, middle, and high school educators are encouraged to bring their students to this event. Schools wishing to attend the event may contact Robert Sabatini, Dean of Students, at 423-869-6849 or email him at robert.sabatini@lmunet.edu. The Commission on Colleges of the Southern Association of Colleges and Schools, or SACS, notified Lincoln Memorial University that it has approved the LMU College of Veterinary Medicine. Approval by SACS clears the way for LMU to enroll students in the program in advance of the August 2014 launch date. LMU received a letter of reasonable assurance from the American Veterinary Medical Association's Council on Education, known as AVMACO, in July 2013. The AVMACO will monitor the progress of the CVM with periodic reports and site visits. According to LMU President B. James Dawson, reaching this point in the development of our College of Veterinary Medicine is a landmark day for this institution, and it demonstrates the investments the university, its faculty, staff, and trustees have made in expanding the educational opportunities for the people of Appalachia. This milestone also highlights LMU's academic integrity, rigor, and standards. LMU CVM's curricula will be delivered in the state-of-the-art Hamilton Math and Science Building, as well as the LMU DeBus College of Osteopathic Medicine. Additionally, LMU has received a grant in excess of $1 million from the Virginia Tobacco Indemnification and Community Revitalization Commission to help fund construction of the Large Animal Teaching and Research Center, and construction is underway in Lee County, Virginia. The College of Veterinary Medicine will be accepting its first class for the fall 2014 session. Forensic radiology is a field that is not even highly advertised, but is climbing the charts with many who are interested in following this career path. Trying to bring more attention to this field is DeBus College of Osteopathic Medicine Dr. Natalie Shirley, who reached out to Dr. Gary Hatch of the University of New Mexico School of Medicine to bring his knowledge of this interesting job to LMU.
Forensic imaging is not new to the field of forensics. I mean, within 2 years of the discovery of x-rays, they were using x-rays in court for both civil and criminal trials. So the utility was recognized immediately. But there was a long period of stagnation where not much new was done. And some of that had to do with the fact no new imaging modalities were devised. With the advent of CT and MRI, there was some early recognition it could be useful for forensic investigation, but nobody really did it. Just some sparse research studies. That started to catch on between about 2000 and 2010, primarily in Switzerland. And that group can really be credited with popularizing, in particular, the use of advanced imaging modalities in forensic investigation. And it caught on quickly all over Europe, Japan, Australia. But that's been slow to catch here in the United States, and I don't really have an answer why. But I think that's starting to change, and I think we're starting to realize as a forensic community that there's tremendous value in these imaging techniques. I'm seeing a lot more interest. There's fewer naysayers and a lot more people saying, hey, how do you do this? You know, I'd really like to try to start doing this. Don't know how yet, but I want to do it. So that's really encouraging. If they've got a case that's unidentified, no dental records, they happen to find some medical imaging, they'll send that to me. I'll do my best to make the comparative matches and to see if we can identify that individual. And that's very fulfilling to do.
Dr. Hatch works as the Assistant Director of the Radiology and Pathology Center for Forensic Imaging and Departments of Radiology and Pathology at the University of New Mexico School of Medicine. He has 16 years' experience in this field and hopes that this presentation opens new doors for a partnership with the universities. Dozens of youngsters from schools in surrounding counties showed their science skills in the Go Green Science Fair right here on the campus of Lincoln Memorial University. The event took place on Friday with the Tennessee Deputy Commissioner of the Tennessee Department of Education, Kathleen Earhart, as the keynote speaker for the event. A total of 25 sixth graders from six counties, including Campbell, Claiborne, Hancock, Granger, Scott, and Union counties, participated in the science fair. Students from each county were selected to advance to the final stage of the competition. Awards and recognition were also presented during the program. The goal of the science fair is to show how students have learned ways to go green and help the planet. Coming up on the next installment of Here at Home, we're going to show you what it takes to care for our and watch after our four-legged furry friends at the Claiborne Animal Shelter. From their everyday routines, including the clinics, the grooming, the cleaning, and keeping them all happy and healthy until they are taken to their forever home. Here is a little preview of those happy faces, and we will have more LMU Tri-State news right after the break.
For efficient, compassionate, and comprehensive health care for you and your family, visit University Medical Clinic. All providers are faculty members of LMU's DeBus College of Osteopathic Medicine and are board certified in their specialty. Multiple specialties available including family medicine, pediatrics, OBGYN, and osteopathic manipulative medicine with locations in Harrogate, Tazewell, and New Tazewell, and most insurance plans accepted. University Medical Clinic is here to serve you. Call 423-869-7193 for an appointment. University Medical Clinic. When you're traveling throughout the tri-states, stay smart at Holiday Inn Express of Middlesboro. With nearly 60 rooms to choose from, fitness center, full complimentary hot breakfast bar, and seasonal pool, Holiday Inn Express of Middlesboro is all about catering to your travel needs. Our rooms are all equipped with flat-screen TV, refrigerator, microwave, and we're conveniently located just seconds from the area's attractions. When you're on the road, stay smart at Holiday Inn Express, located on the Cumberland Gap Parkway, Middlesboro. Make reservations today by calling 606-248-6860.
I will help families adopt children from around the world and in our own backyard.
I am teaching ethics to the next generation of lawyers.
I will make a difference for the underserved of this region.
I will be an advocate for my clients.
As a prosecutor, I fought for those who couldn't speak for themselves.
I'm a lawyer and professor.
I will be a lawyer.
I will be a lawyer.
I will be a lawyer.
If you love your car or truck, let us help you keep it clean at Soapy J's. Soapy J's has unlimited wash plans to fit every budget. Try our $5 express wash or one of our 3 monthly wash plans. The Wheel Deal, the Soapy J, or the new Blast Wax. With our monthly wash plans, if you pay with credit card, all you do is pay for the present month and your card will be billed on the first of each month. Don't forget, Soapy J's has free vacuums with any wash. Soapy J's Express Car Wash, open 7 days a week. Let us help keep your car or truck clean at Soapy J's. Soapy J's on the Cumberland Gap Parkway, Middlesboro.
Although we are now seeing rain and freezing rain in our areas, through the past few weeks, fire departments and Tennessee Forestry have been working hard to keep fires under control. According to Tennessee Forestry, just last week, fires burned from Sunday to Sunday, keeping fire departments on their toes. Friday alone, four departments in Claiborne County worked a brush fire, a debris fire, and a trash pile that blew out of control. The following tips should always be followed when it is safe to conduct a debris burn. Check with local authorities to make sure there are no local restrictions on burning in place. Notify your local fire department and let neighbors know that you have plans to burn. Do not, under any circumstances, burn on windy days. Stay up to date on changing weather conditions and keep fire containment equipment on hand during the fire and stay with the fire until it is completely out. Tennessee Forestry wants to remind residents that burn permits are required through May 15th. Permits are free of charge and can be obtained by calling the phone number for the county in which the burning will be taking place, which in Claiborne County is 869-8275, or by filling out the online form. In addition to this story, Tennessee Forestry officials report that the Smokey the Bear figure that stood next to their building was stolen during last week. They are asking for anyone with information on who may have the Smokey the Bear to contact the Claiborne County Sheriff's Office at 423-626-3385. After spending more than 8 years behind bars, 22-year-old Kenny Bartley was found guilty Friday afternoon of reckless homicide in the 2005 Campbell County High School shootings. He was not found guilty of felony murder or attempted first-degree murder. The jury returned the verdict Friday afternoon, just under 3 hours of deliberations. Bartley was found guilty of reckless homicide in the death of assistant principal Ken Bruce, but not guilty of felony murder. He was also found not guilty of attempted first-degree murders in the shootings of principal Gary Seal and assistant principal Jim Pierce. Guilty verdicts were returned in counts of possession of a firearm at school and possession of a controlled substance. Bartley was released from jail on a $7,500 bond. A sentencing date has not yet been set. Reckless homicide carries a sentence of 2 to 4 years, and Bartley has already served over 8 years in jail. The high-profile case against the Bell County clerk and her two deputy clerks was dismissed by a Pulaski County Circuit Court judge last Thursday. The special judge in the case signed an agreed order to dismiss the case against 46-year-old Rebecca Blevins, 24-year-old Kayla Carnes, and 40-year-old Connie Watkins. The order states Blevins' indictment was dismissed with the stipulation that she not seek re-election or hold any elective office, public office, after the expiration of her present term. This case was dismissed without prejudice. Blevins, Carnes, and Watkins were arrested in November of last year following an investigation by Attorney General Jack Conway's Department of Criminal Investigation. The three were indicted in December. Kentucky State Police remain on the search for a non-compliant sex offender. KSP Post 10 in Harlan is requesting assistance to locate 46-year-old James Kevin Colton of Middlesboro. Colton is a white male with brown hair, green eyes, weighs 180 pounds, and is 5 feet 8 inches tall. He was first made non-compliant during 2012 after failing to verify his address in Bell County. Once a warrant was issued for Colton's arrest, he fled the state, and after several months, Colton was later located in California, where he had also failed to register as a sex offender. Colton was returned to Kentucky to face charges for failure to comply with sex offender registry requirements. Colton's charges were diverted in 2013 by the Bell County Circuit Court for 2 years with the understanding that he would comply with the sex offender registry requirements. As of Wednesday, Colton still had not provided his address or other required information to the Kentucky State Police Sex Offender Registry. Anyone with information on Colton's location can contact KSP Post 10 in Harlan at 606-573-3131. Now, coming up after the break, Adam Plyler brings you your sports update with a preview of what you can expect this week.
No matter whether it's breakfast, lunch, or dinner, Subway of Harrogate and Middlesbrough has your fresh interests at heart. On your way to work, try one of our mouth-watering breakfast sandwich or flatbread omelets. If it's lunch or dinner time, choose from our wide selection of classic, select, or premium sandwiches, all made to your order. If you're serving a crowd, Subway has sandwich platters, giant subs, box lunches, and even cookie platters. Whether it's dine-in or carry-out, you can eat healthy and eat fresh at Subway. Subway, 362 Catawba Avenue in Harrogate and on the corner of the Village Square Mall, Middlesbrough.
It's the Old Town Grill. The Old Town Grill is a special place where you bring more than family, more than friends. Bring a hearty appetite. Because at the Old Town Grill, you'll never walk away hungry. A delicious change from the ordinary. The perfect place to bring the entire family. The best food and plenty of it. Join the fun and treat your appetite to something special.
It's the OTG.
The OTG is the place to be.
Welcome to LMU Tri-State Sports. I'm Adam Plyler. The regular season came to an end in winning fashion Saturday night for both Rail Splitter basketball teams. The ladies extended their winning streak to four games as they knocked off the Catawba Indians 71-62 for senior night at Tex Turner Arena. Katrina Odison came off the bench and scored a team-high 18 points, shooting 4 of 8 from beyond the three-point arc. LMU took a 42-33 lead into halftime and led by as many as 15 early in the second half. Catawba, led by Chloe Bully, went on a 19-5 run to cut the deficit to only 1 point. But the Lady Rail Splitters responded with a 14-2 run of their own to capture the 9-point victory. After the game, the LMU Sports Network Rusty Peace sat down with head coach Roger Hodge about the game and what Wednesday night has in store.
Well, we did have a spurt there at a point in the second half where we got a little loose with it. But, you know, I would agree with you from the standpoint that, you know, probably for 40 minutes it was as well as we played. You know, Catawba's got a good basketball team. And they, you know, again, they're going to keep coming as well. I'm just so proud of our kids. And when your leading scorer has 4 points and you still score 71 points and survive against a really good basketball team, I think that says a lot for the depth. You mentioned, you know, Jasmine Kelly, Miranda Davenport. We were in some serious trouble there in the first half in terms of fouls, and I really didn't want to put Asia and Brittany back in there with two fouls. That's, honestly, you know, the whole bunch of us in this league are all, you know, just so competitive. You know, so Anderson will come up here. They will be ready to play. They're well coached. It'll be a dogfight. We're going to need crowd here, and, you know, I know our kids are going to play really hard, but we'll have to have a great performance to be able to handle Anderson.
The Lady Rail Splitters finished third in this year's final South Atlantic Conference regular season standings. This marks the highest women's basketball league finish since LMU jumped to the South Atlantic Conference prior to the 2006-07 campaign. Wednesday night, for the first time in school history, the ladies are set to host its quarterfinal matchup. Defending regular season and conference tournament champion Anderson University comes in as the sixth seed. The Lady Rail Splitters have won both regular season games against the Trojans. Tip-off is scheduled for 6 p.m. Pre-game festivities begin courtside with Rusty Peace at 5:40. You can listen to the broadcast at 91.3 on your FM dial. Cable customers can watch on LMU-TV, Channel 20. Moving on to men's basketball, the 13th-ranked Rail Splitters finished the regular season in style as LMU pulled out a 110-61 win at home in front of 3,500 fans. Seniors Vincent Bailey and Chance Jones made their last regular season appearance in Tex Turner Arena and combined for 53 points. Bailey had a career night with 34 points and 21 rebounds. Chance Jones added 19 points with 4 rebounds and 2 steals. After the game, head coach Josh Schertz caught up with Rusty Peace to break down Bailey's performance and talk about the upcoming conference tournament.
We're playing better and better, and proud of these guys. It's been a great season. I told them there, now let's go make it a special season. And the special season starts with the most important season. That's the postseason. So it's going to be great no matter what. Now let's make it special. Let's go to work and make this a special year. We got a chance to do some really good things, and hopefully all of our best moments are in front of us.
LMU will host defending tournament champ Wingate University in the quarterfinal round of the Food Lion South Atlantic Conference Tournament at Tex Turner Arena Wednesday night following the women's SAC quarterfinals. You can listen on 91.3 FM or watch on LMU TV Channel 20. Moving on to baseball, the Lincoln Memorial University baseball team won its seventh straight game before dropping one of two games on Saturday. Friday saw the rail splitter stomp Carson Newman 10-2 in Jefferson City. Saturday in game one of the doubleheader, the rail splitters only put one runner on in the first three innings without a runner ever reaching second base. Bo Osmus crushed two home runs as the Eagles soared to a 6-3 victory. Junior Cody Lowe fell to 2-3 on the year with the loss. Game two, however, of the doubleheader saw a different story as LMU used the three-run top of the first to jump out to an early lead. The top of the third saw the rail splitters jump out to an unreachable lead as Scott Miller was hit by a pitch while Kevin Brito and Josh Coker singled to load the bases with one out in the third. A misplayed ball allowed Miller to score on a strikeout while Nolan Woody drove home the second run of the inning with a single. After another rail splitter was hit by a pitch, Jacob West singled in a run. Then Jonathan Lowe put the finishing touches on LMU's seven-run flurry with a grand slam to right center, his first home run of the season. After the weekend series, the rail splitters improved to 10-5-1 on the season, moving to 8-3 in league play. LMU will return to action Wednesday on the road to play UVA Wise. SAC play resumes Friday at home against the Indians from Catawba College. That's all for sports. After the break, Tiffany Duncan will entertain the masses with her entertainment report. That's when you come back. LMU Tri-State News.
Looking for efficient, compassionate, and comprehensive health care for you and your family? Visit University Medical Clinic. All providers are faculty members of LMU's DeBus College of Osteopathic Medicine and are board certified in their specialty. Multiple specialties available including family medicine, pediatrics, OBGYN, and osteopathic manipulative medicine with locations in Harrogate, Tazewell, and New Tazewell, and most insurance plans accepted. University Medical Clinic is here to serve you. Call 423-869-7193 for an appointment. University Medical Clinic. When you're traveling throughout the tri-states, stay smart at Holiday Inn Express of Middlesboro. With nearly 60 rooms to choose from, fitness center, full complimentary hot breakfast bar, and seasonal pool, Holiday Inn Express of Middlesboro is all about catering to your travel needs. Our rooms are all equipped with flat-screen TV, refrigerator, microwave, and we're conveniently located just seconds from the area's attractions. When you're on the road, stay smart at Holiday Inn Express, located on the Cumberland Gap Parkway, Middlesboro. Make reservations today by calling 606-248-6860.
I will help families adopt children from around the world and in our own backyard.
I am teaching ethics to the next generation of lawyers.
I will make a difference for the underserved of this region.
I will be an advocate for my clients.
As a prosecutor, I fought for those who couldn't speak for themselves.
I'm a lawyer and professor.
I will be a lawyer.
I will be a lawyer.
I will be a lawyer.
If you love your car or truck, let us help you keep it clean at Soapy J's. Soapy J's has unlimited wash plans to fit every budget. Try our $5 express wash or one of our 3 monthly wash plans. The Wheel Deal, the Soapy J, or the new Blast Wax. With our monthly wash plans, if you pay with credit card, all you do is pay for the present month and your card will be billed on the first of each month. Don't forget, Soapy J's has free vacuums with any wash. Soapy J's Express Car Wash, open 7 days a week. Let us help keep your car or truck clean at Soapy J's. Soapy J's on the Cumberland Gap Parkway, Middlesboro.
Getting started with our useless entertainment trivia question of the week. What state were some of Beethoven's symphonies performed in before they were heard in Paris, France? I will reveal the answer at the end of the segment. Moving to what's going on in the world of entertainment, Seth Rogen is using his humor in a new way. Rogen has been using his organization Hilarity for Charity to educate young Americans on Alzheimer's. The actor began spreading the word about the disease when his mother-in-law was diagnosed with Alzheimer's at the age of 55, and the disease took its toll on her by the age of 60. Rogan, being an advocate of the disease, was invited to be a part of a witness panel at a Senate Apparitions Subcommittee hearing on February 26th. According to New York Daily News, Rogan impressed lawmakers on his broad knowledge of the subject. He not only impressed the lawmakers, but brought humor to the bleak subject. You can watch Seth Rogan's entire speech on our Facebook page, LMU-TV. The Fox Network is testing a new method of advertising. Double box is what they're calling it, and this type of advertising allows you to keep watching your show. According to Variety, due to the increasing use of DVRs, viewership of commercials is falling. Fox's intent is to get viewership back up and give the viewers more of what they want, their show. Audiences of American Idol have witnessed this technique already. Getting the idea from sports broadcasts, Fox has been testing the new ads in the show for the past two seasons. On February 18th, Fox ran two box breaks, as they call it. As of right now, Fox is only testing the double box ads during American Idol. According to Laurel Bernard, the network's executive vice president of marketing, said that they are considering the strategy for other programming and events with live elements, such as award shows or So You Think You Can Dance. According to Variety, Fox has teamed with Boston-based Interscope Research, who measures responses to ads and programming. Some products being advertised with the double box are Pantene, Coke, and Walmart. I've got one word for you. Bonnaroo. The 24-hour Music and Arts Fest released the lineup for 2014's performers, and according to Los Angeles Daily News, it's the biggest in recent history. Among the list are all-stars like Elton John, Wiz Khalifa, and Vampire Weekend. This is Elton John's first performance at Bonnaroo. Comedians such as Hannibal Buress and SNL's Taron Killam will also be in attendance. All will come together in Manchester, Tennessee, June 12th through the 15th. So get ready for Super Jam Sessions, a mix of mystery artists performing together on stage. So far, there are three scheduled: Ed Helms Bluegrass Super Jam, a Skrillex curated Super Jam, and the traditional Mystery Super Jam. If you, for some reason, get tired of the music, Bonnaroo offers a tent full of comedy and film screenings. So get ready, because tickets are on sale. Now, let's take a look at what movies are headed your way. Get ready for 300, Rise of an Empire. On March 7th, the action continues as Greek general Themistocles will attempt to unite all of Greece. If his plans succeed, he will change the course of the war. Themistocles must also defend against invading Persian forces led by mortal-turned-god Xerxes and Artemisia, a vengeful commander of the Persian navy. 300 Rise of an Empire stars Sullivan Stapleton, Rodrigo Santoro, and Eva Green on March 7th. If you are over action films from the past 2 weeks, you can watch Grand Piano. This drama suspense thriller captures the story of Tom Selznick, the most talented pianist of his generation. After suffering from stage fright and a catastrophic performance for years, Tom reappears for a long-awaited concert. As Tom takes the stage, he notices a message written on the score: play one wrong note and you die. Tom must determine the sniper's motives and seek help, all without anyone realizing. Grand Piano stars Elijah Wood and John Cusack on March 7th. The Tennessee Theater will play host to Stomp on March 7th and 8th. The international percussion sensation consists of an 8-member troupe who uses anything from matchboxes, brooms, Zippo lighters, and hubcaps to fill the stage with magnificent rhythms. Visit KnoxvilleTickets.com for tickets and more information. Moving a little further out, James Gregory, the funniest man in America as he claims, will be entertaining at the Niswonger Performing Arts Center. Gregory's show will take you back in time when life was simpler through storytelling from the front porch. Gregory will only be in town one night, so be ready on March 8th. Visit npacgreenville.com for tickets and more information. Now, it's time to reveal the answer to our useless trivia fact of the week. Some of Beethoven's symphonies were heard in our neighboring state of Kentucky before they made it to Paris, France. Keeping you up to date on what's going on in the world of entertainment, I'm Tiffany Duncan.
And that is going to do it for this week's LMU Tri-State News Update. Thank you for joining us. For everyone behind the scenes, I'm Ashley Hurley.